In this video we will talk about Fujian aircraft carrier's characteristics and features, its advanced mast and electronic warfare, and we will also talk about the type of aircraft it will carry and their firepower. Fujian, named after Fujian province, is the third aircraft carrier of the Chinese aircraft carrier program and the first of the Type 003 class. Previous Chinese aircraft carriers are also named after provinces of China. Built by the Jiangnan Shipyard for the People's Liberation Army Navy, Fujian was launched on the 17th of June 2022 and is undergoing sea trials. Type 003 Fujian aircraft carrier might be closer in displacement to about 80,000 to 100,000 tons. It is without any doubt a supercarrier and one of the largest and most advanced warship built outside United States. The Type 003 is the first Chinese aircraft carrier to support catapult-assisted takeoffs. It has three electromagnetic catapults, two on the bow deck, and one along the aft port towards the angled landing deck exit. On 1 May 2024, the carrier departed from the Jiangnan shipyard and conducted the first sea trial for power, navigation, and electronics systems between 1 and 9 May. It has length of 320 meters or 1,050 feet and it has beam of 78 meters or 256 feet. Its propulsion system consists of 8 boiler steam turbines and 4 shafts generating more than 220,000 horsepower. Catapult-assisted takeoff but arrested recovery, or catapult-assisted takeoff barrier arrested recovery, is a system used for the launch and recovery of aircraft from the deck of an aircraft carrier. The Electromagnetic Aircraft Launch System is a type of electromagnetic aircraft launching system. The system launches carrier-based aircraft by means of a catapult employing a linear induction motor rather than the conventional steam piston. Its main advantage is that it accelerates aircraft more smoothly, putting less stress on their airframes. Compared to steam catapults, the EMALS also weighs less, is expected to cost less and require less maintenance, and can launch both heavier and lighter aircraft than a steam piston-driven system. What's more, the Fujian is not simply imposing, it is also very modern, including onboard an integrated electric propulsion and has a system of 3 catapults and electromagnetic stopping strands comparable to those which equip the newest class of carriers, U.S. Navy aircraft carrier the USS Ford. Fujian aircraft carrier has also 2 elevators to move aircrafts to flight deck from their hangars. It has 6 weapons elevators too. It also has 4 Type 1130 close-in weapon system for air defense. This one is HHQ 10 short-range surface-to-air missiles for air defense. There are 4 HHQ 10, with each having 24 cells. It also has 6 18-tube decoy rocket launchers. These are life rafts. These 4 are high-frequency antennas. These are arresting cables for landing aircrafts. These are bomb jettison ramps. These are helicopter landing spots. That is optical landing system. These 3 are jet blast deflectors. Fujian's integrated advanced mast can carry out radar scanning, electronic warfare and electronic surveillance. While comparing the Chinese and U.S. masts, it seems the Fujian system could be well ahead of the USS Gerald R. Ford's, an advanced all-in-one mast. Its island is enclosed in a grey composite material, a clean and minimalist design which can be seen in many of the Chinese Navy's latest and advanced warships, including the Type 055 destroyer. The principles and modernizations behind this multifunctional integrated electronic mast were recently revealed in a paper by scientists from the Nanjing Research Institute of Electronics Technology who were part of team developing this technology. The modern warship masts house antennas with 3 main functions: radar scanning, electronic surveillance and electromagnetic suppression, but they require antennas of different shapes. The antennas on the Ford gather signals that are synthesized and processed by a computer, by utilizing first generation of electromagnetic sensor integration technology, according to the paper. As the antennas are exposed, it makes them increasingly vulnerable to weathering and performance degradation due to interference from other equipment. The traditional mast configuration is also disadvantageous to electromagnetic stealth, making the ship visible to enemy weapon systems from a distance. According to engineering scientists working on the mast, China has progressed to the second generation of electromagnetic integration technology. Nanjing Institute's team, whose area of expertise is military radar research, had faced a lot of challenges in developing this second-generation electromagnetic integration technology, which means a single antenna can perform multiple roles: radar scanning, intercepting encrypted communications, and carrying out electronic warfare attacks such as jamming and suppression. A high-speed optical fiber connects the antenna encased in the island to a computer, and an operator can adjust the equipment and perform various tasks by simply touching a screen. Because of this innovation and technology, it allows seemingly simple antennas to perform complex functions such as a jamming operation and suppression. A suppression signal is generated by the computer and transmitted to the antenna array after analyzing the gathered signals, and then it emits electromagnetic waves that form a highly focused beam to suppress the target. Before we move forward, we ask you to subscribe Inside Edge 360 YouTube channel. It also has four close-in weapon systems. It is 30mm caliber and has a total of 11 barrels. The Type 1130 close-in weapon system, with a modified radar which some have speculated to be a new active electronically scanned array radar. The rate of fire is 10,000 rounds per minute with maximum firing range of 5 kilometers. It is able to intercept incoming anti-ship missiles up to a speed of Mach 4 with a 96% success rate. It is a short-range surface-to-air missile system with 24 cells. The missile has a range of 9 km against subsonic targets and 6 km against supersonic targets, and a flight altitude as low as 1.5 meters. The system can launch missiles in about 10 seconds. The third carrier might operate the Shenyang J-15B variant, modern fifth-generation avionics, active electronically scanned array, AESA, radar, new airframes, stealth coatings, new engines with possible thrust vectoring capability, and compatibility to launch PL-10 and PL-15 missiles. The J-15B is viewed as an interim carrier-based fighter until a dedicated fifth-generation successor enters service. Its length is 22.3 meters and wingspan is 15 meters, while its max takeoff weight is 32,500 kilograms. It has maximum speed of Mach 2.4 and service ceiling of 20,000 meters. Now armament: it has 30mm cannon, which can fire 150 rounds in air-to-air beyond visual range missiles. It has impressive PL-15 with 200 plus kilometers of range traveling at more than Mach 4 speed. It has another medium range BVR PL-12 which has range of 100 kilometers and travels at more than Mach 4 speed. In short range within visual range missiles, WVR 5th gen PL-10 missile, range 20 kilometers. Impressive turn capability of 60 plus Gs. It has impressive 5th generation PL-10 missile. Flight is controlled by a thrust vector controlled solid rocket motor and free moving control wings on the missile's tail, which facilitate the missile to achieve turn capability of over 60 Gs and high angles of attack. PL-8 short range missile, range 20 km, speed Mach 3.5. YJ-83K anti-ship missile, range 180 to 230 km, speed Mach 0.9 to 1.4 kd-88 standoff land attack missile, range 200 km. YJ-91 anti-radiation missile, range 120 km, speed Mach 3.5. YJ-91 is specifically used against radars. Various other glide, laser and BDU, GPS, guided bombs and rockets. It is a two-seat electronic warfare variant with electronic warfare pods and other electronic equipment installed. Still in development will be carrying PL-15. PL-10 and other munitions which are carried by J-15B to much extent, and might carry next-generation munitions specially designed for 5th-gen fighters. The KJ-600 is a military aircraft cargo and airborne warning and control systems. Overall, it will give massive boost to situational awareness and network-centric warfare capabilities of Chinese Navy. Crew of 5 to 6 people, maximum speed of 693 km per hour range, 1,250 km service ceiling, 15,000 meters, 50,000 feet. It has three-way active electronically scanned array radars arranged in a triangular configuration. It has three variants: Z-18, Naval Transport Variant Z-18F, Anti-Submarine Variant Z-18J, Airborne Early Warning Variant. Capacity: 27 to 30 troops or 15 stretchers or small vehicles or 5 tons of cargo to a range of up to 1,000 km. Max takeoff weight: 13,800 kilograms. Maximum speed: 336 kilometers per hour. Service ceiling: 9,000 meters, 29,528 feet. Armament: up to 4 U-7 ASW torpedoes or YJ-9 anti-ship missiles, up to 32 sonobuoys. Harbin Z-9C. Max takeoff weight: 4,100 kilograms. Maximum speed: 305 kilometers per hour. Service ceiling: 4,500 meters, 14,800 feet. The Z-9C can be fitted with an X-band KLC-1 surface search radar to detect surface targets beyond the range of shipborne radar systems, configured with pulse compression radar, low-frequency dipping sonar, radar warning receiver, and Doppler navigation system. It is also armed with torpedoes.